So we said, Nyangwodo, please support Kanu. Kanu, the IPOB. I said, they are, he sent as a Moses to us. Why are you people? I knew the problem. When Nnamdi Kanu formed what they call BSS, that was the time they now connect to say IPOB. So my husband and I, even while he was in the hospital, were calling Modu. That Mbazurika Mechi, these are the old politicians, I think he's still alive. He just and my husband and I get the telephone number. He called Mbazurika Mechi. Mbazurika, what do you think about all this that is happening? Why don't you people support these young people? That Ojukwu, we all fought for Biafra. Now that you have people, and if they didn't expose all the ills, all the Koshoko, all the killings, I said, would people have known? They saw the history.
Yes.
So what is going on is the same, because if I'm able to get their papers where they show appointments of Fulani, Hausa, you don't tell. If I'm able to come across it, okay. I will.
Anytime
send
you do, you call us.
If I'm able, where they say, nobody is all Hausa. They get. I'll see whether I can find where my husband kept them.
Okay, that's all right. And as a veteran in the various departments of your service, both in Nigeria and in Biafra, what do you think is the best solution to the crisis, this present crisis in Nigeria, especially in the state government?
You say what?
As a veteran in various departments, both in Nigeria and in Biafra. You work for Nigeria, so you are a veteran. You also worked for Biafra during Biafra as a now you are a veteran. And now you must have gathered a lot of knowledge from these two sides. So now everybody knows, is aware of this, of the current crisis and problem of the federal government, especially in Nigeria. So based on your knowledge, what do you think is the best solution?
Excuse me. We want to break away. May let them leave us alone. You say you want, you're killing us. You know, you're killing us, yet you don't want us to go. Let me tell you one thing. My husband worked with them, what do you call it, this company, because he did textile engineering.
Okay.
He worked with them, David Whitehead. They set up the textile factory. Is it in Kaduna? Also, my husband was working with them when they concluded the arrangement to set up this thing. So they said, oh, son, you're going to be a big man in your country. Do you know that Sir James Robertson, the last Governor General, was a very close friend
Lord Rose,
who trained my husband. And Lord Rose, Sir James Robertson, Harold Wilson, who was Prime Minister of Britain, you know that they were very close. Do you know, Ed, I don't know whether you can find the letter and the photograph of Lord Rose.
I will, but not now.
And the wife. To show you, do you know that Lord Rose left England because he was appointed to be one of those that should come because they were talking about Nigerian independence.
Okay.
And coming to Nigeria, he visited my husband's home. My husband's home, you can imagine those dark days. Do you know that Lord Rose called us? He said, listen, my son, when my husband was coming back in 1956, he said, the only way you people would escape is for the East and the West to team up against the North. Otherwise, the North will rule you forever.
And all this thing was said to your husband before the war?
Yes, now.
Okay.
Before the war. Then yes. In 1964, when you're a senior civil servant, they have one book they call, in that book, if you serve government for 5 years, you have the privilege of taking overseas leave.
Okay.
You go, government will be responsible.
Okay.
So me and my husband, in 1964, we now decided to take our leave overseas.
Okay.
We went by air, then we came by sea, okay?
Yeah.
Lord Rose invited us in the house of, in a Britain.
Yeah.
He said, my boy, he called my son, my son, you people are not doing anything. The thing is still as bad. If you people don't take them, because they used to, broadcast in Hausa language in Britain. If you people don't take time, the North will rule you forever. Now, when my husband now came home now, they gave my husband letter to go to be employed by that factory in Kaduna, that textile factory where he was working in Manchester. Do you know that James Robertson, the last
governor,
gave a letter to my husband to go to the chairman. My husband even, and the chairman traveled together from that Kaduna to Enugu, because that time they were the function.
Yes.
And my husband was the one that booked the best hotel in Enugu, because there are two hotels now. I can't remember their names now, but I will still remember.